In fact, we look at two things together in HTS and Honeywell as a whole. I should not be speaking about Honeywell. It's a very well-known company, 36 billion, thousands of patents granted in US and all over the world that, you know, anybody can find out. But what I'm kind of focusing on here is that how we have an integrated management approach to both innovation as well as IP management. So we don't see these two things as two separate things. It's actually very synergistic, need to be done together, need to be done well. And I'll just kind of, it's a very vast subject, so I'm just going to kind of focus on some of the, you know, systems, processes that we have put in place, and, you know, what are the outcomes, and some of the challenges I'll just touch upon. I think this is a no-brainer. We are all here because we realize this, right? So there's a creation process, protection, managing it, exploiting it. Now the creation process is, that's where we talk about the whole innovation management. And then creation is not just filing the patent. That's the point that I just want to make here. Of course, why do you have IP? You know, it gives you competitive, long-term competitive advantage. It kind of adds to your top line and bottom line. One of the, you know, thing that we always talk in our company is that we are innovating the way we want to innovate. The process itself, how do we want to do things? You know, it's the whole process of innovation is highly temporal and contextual. So we realize that. So this is just one such innovation process that we are kind of trying out. You know, focus, what to escape, when to align, and where to move. Now, this is, you know, in a nutshell, the framework where it talks about opportunity exploration. What is the process that we put in place? How do we do that? From what is the starting point? Is it that, you know, it's a fig of imagination in somebody's mind, or there is a starting point? What is the need or problem definition? So if you see here, the key difference is that we just don't start from an idea. We start from the need. What are the critical to qualities, you know, quality factors? What is the next best alternative in the market? It all starts from there. Then we ideate. I mean, this is what we have found is probably one of the good ways of, you know, managing this whole innovation and IP life cycle in conjunction with the product life cycle. Solution building, and then comes IP creation. Or maybe you start thinking much ahead of that. I have seen this diagram many a times, you know. There are incremental innovations, business breakthroughs, technology breakthroughs, and game changers. I have also heard many speakers in previous occasions where people just focus on breakthrough innovations or game changers. What we believe is that everything counts. Everything counts. It all matters, the time, the context, and the business environment. Okay? There are businesses, we have businesses, which is extremely crowded. Every small incremental IP needs to be protected. It's not that every time you will do something great and something which is way out of the way. This is, you know, I am already into my last couple of slides. This is the most important slide according to me. This is what we believe in, this is what we practice, and this is where we have built a certain amount of discipline, I should say. We always very deliberately try to see the connectedness of the synergy and the flow down of the strategy from the business strategy, technology strategy, and IP strategy. We don't want to look at IP strategy as something which is isolated. Like, if you look at the business strategy, it's the computation and the entry barriers which are existing. Look at the existing product line that we have. What are the customer needs? How do our existing product lines address those needs? Is there any gap? It should not be some imagination there. It should be data driven. You know, how these needs, some are explicit, some are not, are being addressed today by our competitors. What is the next best alternative? And if we are thinking about an alternative, what is that value proposition in that? Then it flows down to tech strategy. Now, I mean, this is our understanding, is that not that every business strategy has to have a technology strategy.